So I don't know if anyone wants to really see this video or not, but I'm just gonna walk through how I'm gonna set up my new Mac as an entering medical student and just basically my life, how I like things set up. And we'll just go ahead and do that now. So the first thing I did was install Google Chrome. So I already downloaded it, so I'm just gonna go ahead and drag this into my applications. Okay, now we're good to go. So exit out of that. And just a heads up, I am recording this with a new 24-inch iMac, so this is kind of a test of the microphone setup as well, so you can let me know how that sounds. So we're gonna get rid of this, trash that, and I don't need this DMG folder anymore, so I'll get rid of that. And then we'll add Google Chrome into the dock, and we will trash Safari after I quit it, and it's gone. Great, so first step is done. Okay, next, I really hate this effect in macOS where it's called the genie effect when you are minimizing windows. But if you see this genie effect here, how it kind of genies back there, I really hate that effect and I want to change that. So let me type in genie, it's in the dock settings. And I like to use the scale effect. I think it's just a lot cleaner and a lot faster. And it doesn't obstruct my workflow as much. So we'll go ahead and set that. Okay, that's set. So the next thing I need to do is download a couple of apps that I use pretty frequently. So those are going to be Notion, Spark, Anki, and Notability. And I'm going to rearrange my whole dock here so it fits to the way I like. So let's go ahead and download Anki first. So I've got Anki downloading. I'm gonna go ahead and boot that up and also add that to my dock. So also something else that I like to do is I like to keep my downloads folder empty. So after I'm done downloading something and moving it to the applications folder, I just delete the DMG file so that I don't need it in my downloads folder, taking up space. So Anki is downloaded. And I really hate that Anki hasn't updated their icon. So when I put it in my dock, it's gonna look really ugly, but I really need it to work with all the time. So I'm gonna go ahead and add that there. Something else I really don't like are Keynote pages and numbers. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove those from my dock. Also, Apple News, really don't use that. Can kick that out too. Okay, so the first thing you'll notice here is that to open Anki, you need to install Rosetta. Do you wanna install it now? So why do I need to install Rosetta? Well, I'm on an M1 device now, right? And Anki was built on macOS with the Intel chip. So the new iMacs or the new MacBooks, anything with an M1 chip, we'll need to use Rosetta to basically emulate the program on the M1 chip to make it work. All right, so Rosetta has been installed and Anki should work perfectly fine now. So let's go ahead and boot it up and see how it works. Okay, in the meantime, Anki has loaded up. So let's go ahead and log into that as well. All right, so now what I need to do is click on sync for Anki and basically signed in my Anki account, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Okay, and you can see here it's downloading all my Anki cards. Let's go ahead and download Notion. So go to Mac and Windows, download for Mac with M1. Okay, that's been downloaded, so let's go ahead and add that to our applications folder. In the meantime, I can tell you that I don't use the contacts app, so I'm gonna remove that. And I also don't like having Apple Maps on there, so I'm going to get rid of that as well. And I'm gonna get rid of the mail app because I'll be downloading Spark. So Notion is now here, and I will be adding that to the dock. And you can see now my Notion is all set up. I've got my dashboard, everything I like it, we should be good to go. And actually my technology Notion page, now I can add that, oh, I already added it, that I got the 24-inch iMac here in blue. It's a desktop. Notion is good. Okay, so now let's get some of the apps I used from the App Store instead of online. We'll go to the App Store here. So the first thing we're gonna download is Spark. So that's an email app. I'm also gonna download Final Cut Pro so I can edit this video. So I'll download that. GarageBand is already on here. That's fine. I need Notability. And I'll actually download GoodNotes as well. Even though I don't use GoodNotes as frequently, I won't need it on the dock, but it'll be good to keep. And then we'll need Microsoft Word. We'll actually need the whole suite. I'll download Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and Outlook. I don't use OneNote. Oh, and OneDrive I'll also need. Okay, so a lot of things I downloaded. So let me see where I want everything. So I want this here. I don't use reminders at all. I hate reminders. I don't need Apple TV to be there. I also don't need podcasts to be there. I will keep Apple Music there. That's fine. And let's set up Spark. And then I'm going to add the Microsoft Word Suite in a sec. So let me turn on the notifications from Spark. We will allow notifications. So next we'll add Outlook, or I guess we'll do OneDrive. Oh, well, let's do Notability. So we'll set up Notability here, and I'll just put this down here. It's fine. Okay, I already know what Notability is. And it already signed me in because I just had to use my iCloud account. So that is great. Since that's set up, I might as well set up GoodNotes as well. But I'm not gonna keep that. I'll keep that in the dock. Because I do use GoodNotes on occasion, but I use Notability more. Enable iCloud Sync, and that should be good to go. Because you can make some really, really nice notes on GoodNotes as well, and I really love GoodNotes. But for more practical, everyday usage, I just think Notability is a lot easier to use. Like when I'm using GoodNotes, I feel like I need to make everything look really pretty. Like I made for my cell biology notes. Like, I just feel like I need to make them look really aesthetic. But when I'm using Notability, I don't feel that same sort of pressure. So like, yeah, this is what I was doing for for GoodNotes. I think it looks really good. But if I'm illustrating a book, it's great. But if I just need to take notes, like, I don't have time to worry about that kind of stuff. So OneDrive. OneDrive is a lot. Okay, so I went ahead and got OneDrive set up, but what you can see that's missing here is actually like my home user tab on the left. So I'm gonna go ahead and add that. Finder, preferences. Aha, there it is. Sidebar, okay. So we want this on here. That should be good. All right, so I'll move my home to the very top. And that's where I have my folders. Great. OneDrive for school is now also being synced. So you can see at the top, I've got my OneDrive icons there, which is useful. What else I like to add there is, I like to add sound there. So I know what volume I'm at. I don't like this recents bar at the bottom. So I'm gonna have to get rid of that. So if we go to the dock, show recent applications, get rid of that, that's gone. Great. And that's about it. So hopefully this was just a fun little insight as to how I set up my computer when I need to use it. Once the Microsoft suite is downloaded, I'll have that at the bottom too, somewhere on the dock, so I'll have easy access. But this has gone long enough already. I don't even know if this was interesting. It was fun for me. But I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know how the audio sounds on these microphones on the new iMac, and I'll see you in the next one.